If it's a boy. It's your girl Boss Lady from DrJays.com, and I am here with the one and only Ghostface. I was just telling him that I've been interviewing people for 10 years, and I've never interviewed you, and I'm so excited today. I'm a very big fan.
Appreciate that.
Oh, no, you're welcome. No, welcome. So the new album that's coming out that's being talked about for a minute now is called The Wizard of Poetry.
Is The Wizard of Poetry? Is Ghost Dini The Wizard of Poetry?
Ghost Dini The Wizard of Poetry.
In Emerald City.
In Emerald City?
Yeah.
Oh, it's like Don't Be a Menace While Drinking Your Juice in the
Yeah, it's like from The Wizard of Oz.
Of course.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the album is very R&B themed. We know you've always had a soul focus to your music, but you're bringing in a lot of current R&B artists to share the load with you on this album.
Right.
And the song that I've heard already is Baby with Raheem Devon. And
okay,
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. I mean, Ghost, one of the things about you that's great that I think a lot of rappers have never been able to manage, but you do it effortlessly, is speak to the fellas and speak to the ladies and show your respect for both.
Mm-hmm.
So talk a little bit about where you got the idea to do this particular album with the intriguing title.
Basically, the R&B album, I always wanted to do an R&B album. You know, I always wanted to do an R&B album because I felt like when I tell stories, like I know how to do all of these drug raps and, you know what I mean, and talk about the block all day and my jury and, you know what I mean, all types. But I always wanted to like do an album of just like me singing to women, you know what I mean, and not just to women, but telling my story, even whether it's for a man situation, you know what I mean,
good
and stuff
and bad
like that.
Times.
Like, yeah, exactly. It could be about the kids. It could be whatever.
Right.
You know what I mean. But I always think that I'm better when I paint a picture, and I think people, you know what I mean, I'm not saying like me better, but you know, could feel me more when I'm painting a picture.
So we're gonna go back through Ghostface's career, from the first solo album. We're gonna do a style profile on you being from DrJays.com.
That's my word. I plug something. If you front on my back and my name ring, ran away, girl, she the sweetest thing. I love
you. Back then, you had a lot of guests. You had guests.
Polo?
You got Polo, guests, Tommy Hilfiger, you know what I mean? Whatever was hot around, you know, Carl Kanai was bubbling in those days, you know what I mean? In the around 96 and all that stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I had a mountain full of wallabies, you know what I mean? So that's like when you look at the cover of the Iron Man cover is very colorful, you know what I mean? And the wallabies, it was like I was in a factory, you know what I mean? Me, Raekwon, and Cat, we was just up there, like if that was a factory, and that's what we pushed out.
Were you maturing in style a little bit? Is that when the gold jewelry really came?
I was maturing because, you know, Iron Man was cool, but at that time it was kind of weary.
Mm.
It was kind of dark in my life, you know what I mean? And when you got the Supreme, it felt more flavorful, more fruitful, like, you know what I mean? At the same time, those are based on whatever you're going through at that period of time. You feel me?
Yeah.
When I got the Bulletproof wallets, it was just, to me, just as good as Supreme. Maybe not as funnier because I had like a lot of live skits on Supreme.
Right.
But what happened to wallets, they took a couple of songs off, which threw my record off course. You know what I mean? They took the watch off. They took important songs off, like The Sun. You know what I mean? With Slick Rick. They took important songs off, so it was like, damn. And I had to, and they had to change up a few beats based on sample clearances. You know what I mean? So
the vibe,
like,
kind of switched up for
totally,
that.
Totally.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's how people don't look at that album like how they looked at Supreme.
Mm.
You feel me?
Mm. Damn. Pretty Tony is such a popular album amongst people that may not have even been Ghostface fans before Pretty Tony. And like Pretty Tony, you came out with is that when the robes really got heavy around 2004? Pretty Tony was kind of like a little more of a mature Ghostface.
Exactly.
Yeah, compared to the others.
Yeah, the robes, yeah, because in a couple of videos I did use the robe. I used it a few times in a couple of photo shoots and all that stuff around the Pretty Tony.
Yeah.
And
Pretty Tony himself is a little bit more chill, right? Is Pretty Tony kind
of
chill?
it was just, you know what I mean? It was just like
grown man ghost.
Exactly. I stopped wearing that based on that there wasn't enough masses for me to wear like that. You know what I mean? It was like, okay, you always see me with a stocking cap on my head or maybe a bullshit mask, but it wasn't a mask. I needed an ill mask. I couldn't find nobody to make me an ill mask where I could... When you got a stocking cap, it's hard to talk through your stocking cap and be clear on a mic at the same time. Can't do that. You know what I mean? So I had to do one or the other. You know what I mean? I had to breathe, nigga.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So I had to take that off. I didn't want to take it off, but I had to get ahead and, you know.
Because there was no other alternative.
Yeah. Now, if I had a ill mask, you know, that had the mouthpiece, the nose piece and all that, I probably would have took it off not too long ago, but you know, but it would have lasted a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, and even with Theodore Unit, back in like 2005, he did the Letterman jackets. Like, you've really switched it up over the years.
I mean, you know, you just. I mean, I love what I do. I love rap music. Don't get me wrong. I love this.
Yeah.
And I know that is meant for certain people. You understand what I'm saying? It's like you might not be the best MC that's out there, but if your stars line up and music for you, you gonna go places. But it's like for me, you know what I mean? I know, and I'm not gonna say no names, but I know a lot of these guys. I know I could, I mean, because this is like a competition, but I know I could beat it. I know I could. You know what I mean?
But because you don't even need to say it.
No, I don't have, I don't need to say it, but I know that my pen game, you know what I mean? And I ain't sucking my own dick, but I know my hand, my right hand is probably one of the illest right hands in the game when it come to writing. You know what I mean? But I'm not the multi-millionaire dude. You know what I mean? He is. You know what I'm saying? So his stars lined up for him. Even if he dropped a bullshit album, it's probably going to sell because his stars is aligned for him. You know what I mean? And that's just how it works.
So I could talk to you all day, but we're going to have to wrap it up now. So the album is called Ghost Dini, The Wizard of Poetry in Emerald City.
Emerald City, that's right.
It's coming out a little later on this year.
Yeah, we don't have a date. What we're going to do, we're going to drop the first single.
Yeah.
We're just going to just like get the streets buzzed up, warmed up. I'm going to be doing a lot of stuff, a lot of records and stuff like that. Just get it buzzed up, because every time you put a date on something and your record is not where at the peak that it's supposed to be, like especially on spins on the radio, things kind of like...
It tarnishes the whole release.
Yeah, exactly. Now you got to rush to hurry up and put it out, and it's like you ain't really got to look.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. And so you've been around for a minute, so you don't need to worry about that type of thing anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So I don't even care. Long as the buzz is right and everything is good and everybody feel like it's time to go ahead and drop it, then I guess we'll drop it. I don't care about
that. And bringing it back to what we started off with, the fashion and the style, how would you describe your style today? As a grown man,
my style is more, you know what I mean, on a mature look. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I'm still the same ghost. Don't get me wrong. I still love fly shit all day.
Because we skipped Big Doe Rehab, and that's when you had like the Tony Montana suits and kind of like.
Oh yeah,
no doubt,
red and white. That's my favorite colors.
Yeah.
Boom. But what I do now, I have my man. I take a lot of my clothes that I always like, whether I bought it or not, and I would bring it to my man, and he'd make it over for me. He'd make it, you know what I mean, with whatever I want to do.
He's like the new Dapper Dan.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like when he got these jeans, I told him, I said, yo, I told him to take a pair of Levi's, yo, take these Levi's, do my pockets like that, and it's like, and it'll come out cheaper than what, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
$100 and $200 jeans, I could get them done for even way less than that.
Well, Levi's are the classic. Like, you know, on DrJays.com, we sell out of Levi's like that.
Yeah, yeah,
Levi's.
You know what I mean? Just because they hard, they crunchy. I don't like soft jeans.
Right. Really. So you do the casual look when you need to, but when you need to get dressed, you get dressed.
I got blazers and all that. Yeah. You know what I mean? And shirts like that, of course. You know what I mean? So it's like, however you want to, you know, it's just anywhere you could go.
Yeah.
Anywhere you know what I mean?
Well, it was such a pleasure. Yeah. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Make sure you check out the single that's out now called Baby with Raheem Devon.
Yeah.
Beautiful track for the ladies.
Right.
Yeah, talking about the women that you care for. And
it's all good.
You're the best,
it's
man.
Good.
Thank you so much. Make sure you check out a legend, Ghostface. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Ghostface.